economist of the opposition.
That's
very
amazing.
Strongly opposed to Maduro, but he's a harsh critic of the sanctions because they're just devastating the population. His own estimate is about a year or two ago, that they'd killed about 40,000 people. I suppose there was a military coup that overthrew the government, threw out Congress, imposed a new president, eliminated the Supreme Court, supported by the New York Times and CBS, let's say. And then the coup was put back. Would they have lost their license? I mean, they'd all be put before firing squads and killed.
How about not sanction them? How about allow them to feed their people? How about allow medication to get through?
This film is a shot against the establishment, an establishment which silences the press from speaking important truths. I'm David Tornheim, co-director of Embassy Protectors. What are Embassy Protectors? We're a group of activists which converged on DC in May and April of 2019. We went to the Venezuelan Embassy to stop it from being seized from the U.S. government. The U.S. government wanted to turn it over to an unelected right-wing puppet government that the U.S. administration supported and tried to back with a coup. The media, following the propaganda fed them by administrations of both Democrats and Republicans, will not tell you that Venezuela has one of the best voting systems in the world, or that Nicolas Maduro is the elected leader of the country and recognized by the UN as such. They will not tell you that the Trump administration recognizes a man who is unelected and virtually unknown to the Venezuelan, who simply proclaimed himself interim president of Venezuela at a public rally. The mainstream media will not cover people who oppose imperialist activities of the U.S. administrations against countries to topple democratically elected leaders. Consider the media coverage of the Iraq War. Did you ever hear any opposition to the war in the mainstream media? Instead, they put up images of mushroom clouds. This is why we went to D.C. We wanted to put a stop to this madness of the U.S. regime change.
My name is R Suarez. I'm the co-director of Embassy Protectors. Our film is going to cover the events that transpired at the Venezuelan Embassy in D.C. in May of 2019, but also will lead up to it in the lives of the diverse group of activists involved, including veterans, whistleblowers, and four political prisoners of the U.S. Soon after Julian Assange was forced out of the Ecuadorian embassy in London, another embassy began its crisis here in the U.S. This film is going to show us, go throughout the country, and show a side of activism rarely seen by the American people. The lengths the government can go to try to support inept public government and the right-wing exiles in the U.S. Like the Twilight Zone, this may seem unreal to you, but we assure you, this is absolutely a true story. Nothing's embellished. We show you the pure truth on film. People of color and the working class activists were at the forefront of trying to defend our fellow protectors from the siege of the Venezuelan embassy in D.C. We are going to uplift their voices in this sacred film that is almost complete. This is what the so-called mainstream does not want you to see. Welcome to Embassy Protectors.
When I say counter-hegemonic narratives, I'm trying to show that there are another versions of the stories that especially U.S. people are not aware of, because they are really used to the mass media and the mainstream media in this country. That's why we don't usually see in the mainstream media people of color given their experiences.
We could easily see that the majority of people outside, or if not the majority, a good percentage of the people outside and some people inside were people of color.
I was honored to be a guest of the late former President Chavez on two different occasions.
Pero si no es Julian Assange.
por supuesto, ¿no? Lo de Julian Assange es algo, es una ubicación definitiva en conceptos humanos que no les agrada a los capitalistas.
I also blew the whistle on the CIA's torture program. I'm a firm believer that whistleblowing is essential to the health of a democracy. You can't have a real democracy without transparency. And without transparency, you can't have a functioning political system.
Shortly after Al and I met in front of the embassy, Dr. Margaret Flowers called from inside, saying that the exiles were trying to break in through the back. We quickly formed a plan to investigate, and a homeless man who was there to show support, named Eric, filmed us.
Okay, we know we're not breaking. talk to them.
All right, thank you.
Cedar Shore showed little interest in addressing the break-in. David brought Russ and I back to the embassy to make a surprise run to try to break through the exiles and Secret Service human barricade. That blocked us from both seeing where the exiles were trying to break in or close the door to keep them from entering.
I was hit from behind with an umbrella by an exile, but police did nothing. We have further audio of this, but it was dark, so no visual. This is nothing, however, in comparison to those of us who had serious injuries.
I went to Venezuela when I was there, people were living good. Hugo Chavez built houses, big houses.
Eres testigo de los primeros venezolanos que llegaron a la ciudad. Si nos quieres contar un poco sobre eso.
No, so I got dragged. I was tech dragged in.
I don't really think that the Venezuelan embassy in D.C. was just the beginning of the systematic violation of international law.
I was still working at the Carter Center in 2000, and that was during the presidential election. And so, of course, the press came to President Carter and said, well, look, you know, you're monitoring elections all over the world. Please go down to Florida and monitor the recount in Florida. And I will never forget this as long as I live. President Carter's response was, we cannot monitor elections in the United States because the United States does not have elections.
The government, it doesn't matter who is in the White House, they are always supporting coups.
They showed that the CIA had been involved in overthrowing governments, going back to 1953 in Iran, Guatemala in 1954, Chile in the 1970s. So you can look around the world, they say it's something like over 80 countries now, I believe, that the U.S. has played a role in facilitating, pushing for regime change.
One thing I will never, ever forget is seeing a young white Venezuelan woman scream at two young black guys that they were showing white, they're showing their white privilege by being there protesting this illegal takeover.